Hello guys, it's me again, Aswad, and today I'm gonna talk about Robinhood, GameStop, and Wall Street. What I'm gonna do is I want to make it a very simplistic discussion about the three things that's going on in the news right now relating to Robinhood, GameStop, and Wall Street. And I want to make it very simple because you can read, you can see other videos that go into details about it. So first, let's go understand what is Robinhood. So Robinhood is an app that came out about a few years back, I think, that help people who does not have any connection on how to get into Wall Street, how to go into trading, how to buy and sell shares, and they can access this app and try to buy shares from the phone. And it has been up to this recent January situation, it has been very successful. A lot of people in United States use this app to buy stock, shares, and whatnot to trade. Okay, so Wall Street is a place where, you know, all the stocks trading as well. I'm not gonna go into deep. What you know, what's going on, but the center of this situation is GameStop. So now, the gist of the situation is GameStop is a company that is almost close to bankruptcy. It's nothing happens here. Nobody goes into it anymore. People are buying stuff online, and it's pretty dismal for this company. So the people on Wall Street, the stockbrokers and the hedge funds, all these big companies that trade in stocks, they plan to buy this share from GameStop in a way that they can make profit. Now they are not thinking about making the stock goes up. They want to make the stock goes down, so then they can make money. You see, stock trading in Wall Street, you can also make money if the stock goes up or if the stock goes down, right? Okay. So Wall Street, a lot of these hedge funds, all these trading companies and whatnot, these big companies, they want to make money by selling, by making sure that the stocks here are going down. Okay, so what happened is, as long as the stock goes down, GameStop stocks go way down, then this business, these companies will make money. Like I said, I'm doing a very simple explanation for people who wanted to know more. So Robinhood, the people who are using this app, which make it easy for them from homes to, and who doesn't have any knowledge of the, you know, the complexities of Wall Street, the people using this, instead of following, they heard about all this plan to bring down the stock of GameStop, right? What these people do, instead of buying down, they buy up. Meaning they buy the stocks, wanting it to go up. When it buys, it goes up. The Wall Street people, companies, who wanted the stocks to go down to make a profit, they began to lose money. Let's not go deep. Why? The explanation, because the purpose of their mission is to make sure the stock of GameStop goes down. Instead, people from Robinhood buy up. So when they do that, then Wall Street businesses, all these big brokers and whatnot, all these hedge funds and companies, they are starting to lose billions. All right, because they invested so much for the stocks to go down. Instead, it goes up, then they are losing billions. Okay, right? Up and down, up versus down. Wall Street wants the stocks to go down. People using Robinhood wants the stock to go up. It's not just Robinhood. There's a few more apps that helps normal people to buy stocks. But for this purpose of this video, we're going to focus on these three simple things, simple players. So the people on Robinhood buys up, right? Now, the dilemma, the situation that happened that bring this controversy up front is that Robinhood all of a sudden stopped the users from buying more GameStop stocks. They stopped the purchase of these stocks. And the people who are Robinhood users are very angry, you see, because now the GameStop stock is going way, way up, and going up, 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 and Wall Street is going down. They're losing a lot of money. So in the middle, GameStop just stopped the trading. Alright, and people are angry. Why can't we buy more stock? Why can't we buy more stock? Because this company stopped them from buying more stocks. Okay, now the simple discussion, why did Robinhood stop the trading on this app? It's very simple. Robinhood is owned by Wall Street. It's not fully owned by Wall Street, but a lot of the brokers, like I said, the businesses earlier who were planning to for the stock to go down, they own a big part of Robinhood. They fund Robinhood. Robinhood is owned by Wall Street. Okay, get it. So when Wall Street companies are losing money because of the situation here in GameStop, there must be communication, because they own Wall Street, big company in Wall Street own Robinhood. There is a suggestion that one of those companies ask Robinhood to stop the trading. Okay, to stop the trading. And that is why Robinhood had to stop. Why? Because the people that pay for Robinhood are from Wall Street. If they lost their money because of the situation with GameStop, they can no longer fund Robinhood. Do you understand? So in order Robinhood to continue to survive, it must help the company that financed it. So Robinhood choose to stop to stop the trading in order to help the big company in Wall Street. Now, that is what is going on. Why Robinhood stopped it? Because if Robinhood does not stop the trading, Robinhood will be closed down. Because the company that is funding Robinhood will also go down because of this situation, the GameStop situation. Okay, now, that is in the simplest term why all of this is happening. You know, not a conflict of interest in a way it is, but it is the flaw of the system. Because the word the people are arguing, Robinhood means a guy who robs the rich and gives to the poor. So the idea of Robinhood to help normal people make money on Wall Street, which is right now is being controlled by all these big companies. But the big companies also own Robinhood. So that is the reason why Robinhood has to stop the trading in order to survive. He doesn't have a lot of money. All the money that he has the majority of the investment come from company in Wall Street. That company will fall if this situation goes on with GameStop. And they are going fall. They lost already billions. Now, they had to do this emergency move for Robinhood to stop trading. Right? Okay, now that's the most simplest discussion about why. What was the mistake that I think could have been avoided? Now, Robinhood is being sued by a lot of people. They are trying to sue the company. And the company came out with statement after statement after statement. Now, the problem with it is the statement did not tell the truth. I was listening to the CEO, very young chap, talking about Cuomo on TV, why he stopped the trading. He never explained, like I just explained to you. He never explained why Robinhood had to stop because it was owned by the company that's losing money, which is in Wall Street. He never explained that. And he was explaining that he was trying to help the little people, the investors, and the little normal guys. At the same time, he had to stop the trading because of the stock regulation and whatnot, Wall Street regulation. Bullshit. I think that was the biggest problem that Robinhood brought upon themselves because of that kind of answer. The situation could have been remedied, could have been less problematic if they admit the truth. The truth is, Robinhood, if it does not stop the trading, it will stop existing. Because the big company is in Wall Street. The mothership, the big financial of this app is from here, from Wall Street. If he explained that, he had to stop the trading in order for it survival, then it is, like I say, it might not be the best news, but at least it's the truth. When they give the question, when he answer it in terms of roundabout way of trying to follow regulation, that's bullshit. There's no regulations and whatnot. He was not being honest with the investor and the people and the media. They should have done it. Because the truth is, either way, Robinhood is screwed. One, being lying to people. Because they stopped the trading, he already lost the trust of the people. And then they create all these lies. They are not telling the truth. They are not. People are suing them. Because if they had tell the truth, like they don't have money, they are losing money. Actually, because of GameStop situation, Robinhood is indirectly losing money from Wall Street company that fund this. The funder of the Robinhood is also a hedge fund that is also losing money because of the GameStop situation. So that's the only explanation they should have given to the people. And then bear the brunt of it. At least if they tell the truth, and then some of the people can say, okay, they tried their best, but what, you know, the understanding will come, because then they had to stop the trading or else they will stop. You know, people will still be angry. At least people know they are telling the truth. Now people are angry because there seems to be something shady going on. And regulation will come in. They will be called up to Congress and whatnot. I'm sure of it, because AOC is just starting to look into this matter. But I also heard the AOC streaming on Twitch, on Discord. I think I opened it on Discord or Twitch. The live streaming that she did on her Twitter. She was talking to an expert and they were explaining in quite detail. So this is my simple breakdown, the simplicity of it. And it could have been solved, could have been finished, if Robinhood being honest with the investors, the media and whatnot. The truth is, they were just trying to survive. They stopped the trading, because if they didn't stop the trading, they will shut down. Because their fund, their source of money is from a company, hedge fund in Wall Street. The one or the Wall Street players, the big, big players who are losing money because of the GameStop thing. Okay, that is the very simple discussion on this. My thoughts on this, the financial system has always been flawed in America, in Wall Street, but that's what it is, you know. There's from Obama or whatnot, all these kind of presidents, they never think about changing it because it's a lot of people are making money out of it, you know. It's a flawed system, but a lot of people are making money. It is when Robinhood started showing up and the GameStop fiasco started to show up, then it opens the, like, reveal that big flaw of Wall Street. You know, whose fault is this? Obama, the Wall Street system has been existing in America for a long, long time. It's never, nobody want to change it. Because, like I said, if the GameStop situation doesn't happen, did not happen, these people will still make money. Wall Street will always make billions, billions every year. You know, that's has always been the bread and butter of the American economy in the long term. That's why nobody wants to change the system, because it has flaws, but nobody wants to change it because so many, the reason it has flaws and the reason why they don't want to change it is because Wall Street can use the flaws for their own advantage. All these big companies, all these big hedge funds, investors, brokers, they use the flaws to make more money, more money, more money. That's why the stock broker, the Wall Street have collapsed a few times because of this flaw. But nobody want to change it. Obama did not want to change it. Bill Clinton is even worse. Bill Clinton is even worse, I think. He actually put the fund, he actually strengthened Wall Street, Bill Clinton. Of course, nobody want to touch it. Not Bush, not Trump, especially not Trump. They all make money off of Wall Street. It's a flawed system that was revealed because of this small company and also the people who buys through Robinhood this stock. You know, normal people who are using this simple app. Now, Robinhood now is in the crosshair because of this bad PR stunt. PR stunt in terms of how they respond to the media and the investors. You know, they should have come up with the honest truth that they are not actually Robin Hood. They have always been the sheriff of Nottingham. Robin Hood, if you follow that story, in this scenario, Robin Hood has always been working for the sheriff of Nottingham. That's it. And they don't want to admit it because they have been selling themselves as Robin Hood. We are helped but steal from the rich and giving it to the poor. No. You are working for the sheriff of Nottingham, Wall Street. That's it. And that is my short and simple video on the matter. You know, it's not perfect, but at least some gives you some light. Thank you guys for your time. Please like and subscribe.